love movies? I know I do. Today, we get to go behind the scenes of a theater to see how they use math every single day. From figuring out how much a ticket costs to pricing the popcorn, math is used in almost every aspect of a theater. Join me as we go behind the scenes of a theater to see how it's math. Let's get into it.
Doodly doodle, doodly doodles and digits. Area, symmetry, fractions too, it's all here for you.
My name is Ryan Bowie, and I'm the executive director at the Avalon Theater in Marysville, Ohio. The Avalon Theater is a nonprofit cultural arts center. We do a wide variety of events, from classic films to comedians to concerts to live plays. You name it, we do it here at the Avalon.
How do you use math?
The theater itself has 236 red velvet seats. We have several rows in the center section that have 10 seats across. We're in multiples of 10. And then on the side sections, we either have 3 or 4 seats coming back, depending, because it kind of comes back at an angle. We have a full concessions area that patrons use when they come in to see a show or a movie, and that requires counting money. So a lot of times we will take a bottle of water that might cost us $1, and we're going to mark that up 50%, or maybe 60%, so that we cover our costs, but then we're also making a little additional. We have come up with a ticket price of $8 for all of our movies. We want it to be affordable. Some of our live productions are a little bit more expensive because they cost us a little bit more on the back end, and so we need to recoup some of that or pay some of those performers. We have to deal with something that's called royalties, and that makes sure that everybody that has worked on the movie is getting paid appropriately for all of their hard work that went into it. So let's say we're going to show a popular holiday movie, and it's going to cost me $380 for the royalties, and then make that payment back to that royalty company. So we have movies that are coming out, and we know about them, and they're going to be new releases. They cost a lot more to show, and also they want you to show it a minimum number of times. Sometimes they want you to run those for at least 2 weeks, sometimes 1, 2, 3 times a day, 7 days a week. Then there's other options for movies that have been around for a long time, and those are at a lesser price point. While they are a lower price point, it also helps us justify keeping our ticket price lower. So movies always have a runtime, 1 hour and 26 minutes. One of the main reasons we use it is we do partnerships with other businesses. There is a dessert place right next door. It's an ice cream parlor. If the movie starts at 2 o'clock, the movie runs 1 hour and 26 minutes, they can expect to get their ice cream at 3:30-ish, depending on if they want to sit around and watch all the credits.
What advice do you have for math students?
Truth be told, I was terrible at math, but I never thought that my day-to-day life would deal with so much addition, subtraction, fractions. Sometimes I wish that I would have paid a little bit more attention in those classes, because you're going to need it.
You go to the movie theater and want to purchase snacks at the concession stand. You get 2 drinks and a popcorn. The drinks cost $2.50, and the popcorn cost $3.75. How much do you spend in total? You spend $8.75 in total. Did you get it correct?
A lot of you probably have a local theater somewhere in your community. Continue to support that, because it's super, super important for us as a society to have arts and cultural outlets so that we can continue to grow and we can continue to become awesome human beings. This is the Avalon Theater, and this is How It's Math.
Want more information about how math is used in the real world? Make sure you check out our website, www.doodleslearning.com. Bye!